In this series of videos, we're going to learn how to actually make 3D glasses like you would use at a movie theater. More importantly, besides just making them, we're actually learning how to make the material itself right there, okay? And these glasses actually consist of two technologies depending on which way you look at the glasses. And the way that they're used in the movie theater, they consist of actually something called a circular polarizer. But they're actually based on another technology called linear polarizers. So again, we're going to synthesize the material, and we're going to make linear polarizers, and then we're going to make circular polarizers so we can actually use the, or learn the usefulness of learning a bit of chemistry right there, okay? Now, this is not to be confused, okay? Again, these are the ones that are for the 3D movie glasses, the modern ones right there, right? This is not to be confused with old-styled movie glasses, these red-blue glasses, also called anaglyph glasses, okay? These don't allow as much light right there. And in fact, for older people like myself right there, you may actually see a more double image with these type of glasses right there because of the fact that the corneas are actually yellowing right there. There's some famous painter, I remember, forget his name, where he actually drew pictures of things before and after he had cataract surgery. And so therefore, you know, that's a, and viewing these actually in the 90s, right, there's this, I remember having an issue of this, of course, because our cornea yellows right there. Okay, so that's not what we're talking about. And the 3D movie glasses, they're related to these, okay? In truth, these are actually old style 3D movie glasses, but they look like sunglasses. Don't ask me why like this, but here's a piece of a pair of sunglasses right there, okay? They are related, but the 3D movie glasses would not be used for sunglasses. And that's something important that you should learn right there, right? Now, of course, all this stuff, again, we're going to learn how to make synthesized linear polarizers and then make circular polarizers. But all of this is related. These polarizers are actually, they exist in all kinds of technologies. Okay, but before we get that, okay, to show you that they are in all these technologies, let me just show you first the basis of all of this, which is linear polarizers. These are two commercial linear polarizers right there, right? And so when you look at things, okay, so for instance, let me turn this right here, this sheet right here, right? Or better yet, let me look at this wall right here so you can see through something right there. So when you can see through the polarizers, okay, so can you see there right there? I have them against the screen right there, right? Then we say that they are actually a line right there, okay? But when you turn them so that you can't see through them, okay, so for instance, in this case right here, right, I'm going to turn the front one and see how you can see, and then you don't have the other you can't see right there. Well, what did I do? Here they're aligned, so you can see through the polarizers right there, and here they're what? Here they're crossed right there, right? You can even see a reflection of me on here, okay? So the way I'm going to be showing you things right there is I'm going to have one of the polarizers in front of the camera right there, right? And then the other one right there, right? I'll turn it right there so you can see that either the polarizers are aligned or they're crossed right there, so you can't see anything through them right there, right? Okay. Okay. This reminds me when I was a kid. There was a kindergarten show. I remember there was a lady, I think they call it a magic mirror. You can look it up. I think it was called Romper Room. And supposedly her face appeared and disappeared in front of the little mirror or the glass that she was using right there, right? And so, you know, now that I know about optical polarizers right there, then I realize, well, they probably had one of these things in front of the camera, and the other one was, well, rather than turning this one, they were actually turning the one in the camera. So it goes from being light to dark right there, okay? Okay, so you can identify a linear polarizer by crossing. In other words, they're angle dependent right there, right? Okay, and I can show you that here, but this is gonna be a little strange right there. Yeah, this is the way that usually you put the glasses on right there, right? The thing is that if I turn this polarizer right now, or if I turn the lenses right there, right, you can see that definitely it gets dark right there, right? Okay. But if you turn it the other way right there, it doesn't really affect it right there. You might see a little bit of color change, but I hope you can still see. I'm actually turning the linear polarizer right there, right? Okay. So what it is right there is that these 3D glasses actually consist of both linear and circular polarizers. And so therefore, you have to make a linear polarizer before you make a circular polarizer. Okay. Okay. But let me show you again, you know, how important this stuff is in technology. Okay. So again, I have the linear polarizer in front of the camera, and then I'm going to turn on, this is a, this is difficult. We call them liquid crystal displays right there, right? And so this one's difficult to work with right there, but because it's actually needs some light right there. This one of those solar cell one right there. But I hope you can see that what I can do right there, right, is depending on the angle that I turn my linear polarizer, the screen goes what, light and dark, right? And so here where you see the most light right there, the polarizers must be aligned. And in this case, where it gets the darkest right there, right? Let's see. Where it gets the darkest right there, then the polarizers must be crossing right there, right? Okay. Of course, there's another effect that's affecting here, but I'm going to talk about that later. Okay. Okay. So linear polarizers are found in all kinds of liquid crystal displays. So of course, there was calculators, and here's another example. Again, I have what a watch, right? A kid's watch right here, right? Okay. And now you'll notice this doesn't actually work. Okay, if you get yourself either a pair of sunglasses, or if you get yourself, you know, or you have some, if you kept the movie glasses right there, right? Remember, you're gonna have difficulty because in one orientation these are circular, and the other orientation they're linear. But you can see all these effects for yourself right there much better than through this little video that I'm trying to show you right here, right? Okay, of course. Phones are something also to consider, and this you might have difficulty because this is one thing about it. Okay, let me go back over here, right? Well, let me show you this phone again right there, just to prove you this has a linear polarizer because I have a what? I have a light, and then of course, why is it going light and dark right there? It's not because the light is turning off; it's because I'm turning the polarizer in front of the camera. Well, now it went dark. Okay, I'm turning the polarizer in front of the camera, so they're crossed, and there you can see on that, right? Okay, but you'll have issues to try to see this. This is an older phone right there. In this, maybe in modern phones right there, because one of two reasons. One of them is that just like I was trying to show you right now, right? In this orientation, you can see that. In fact, let me get another pair of. These are the movie glasses I just took off the I just took off the side arms right there, right? So that it wouldn't interfere with the filter right there, right? So in one orientation right there, definitely these are what these are linear polarizers that you have here right there. See how things have gotten dark right there, right? Okay, and then I've made it go light right there, right? But in the other orientation, these are circular polarizers, right? And that's the thing to discover on this thing right there. And so you'll notice in the circular polarizers right there, right? As you turn your head right there, then they're not angle dependent as much. Well, they may change color a little bit, but they're not angle dependent right there. Yeah. And this is actually very important. I was telling you that these are really 3D movie glasses right there, right? But they're old style 3D movie glasses that actually are using the linear polarizer. In fact, let me put them on here and you can see how it gets light and then it gets what? It gets dark if I turn in one orientation or another right there, right? And that's meant so that when you look at the movie right there, right? One eye sees, I don't know if you've ever taken your glasses off when you're watching a 3D movie, but it looks blurry. You're actually being shown two images at the same time, okay? So how do you block this? Well, you put on the glasses so that the left eye only sees the eye, the image that's meant for the left eye, and the right eye only sees the image that's meant for the right eye. Because of course they put the images are in the projector right there. They're actually the projectors are actually emitting polarized light, or light that goes through one of these filters. Okay, sorry if I'm using sometimes some jargon right there. Okay. Okay, so these are old style 3D movie glasses, and you can tell that because you see, again, I can use a linear polarizer to identify them just by crossing right there and going from light to dark right there, right? But again, the modern 3D movie glasses right there, what happens right there, right? On one side they're linear polarized right there, but on the other side they're circular polarized, and they're not angle dependent right there, right? In fact, here's a cardboard version, or some cardboard versions right there of a 3D movie glasses right there, right? And this happened in the 1950s right there, right? But these are all angle dependent, okay? You know, just like the clip-on that I just showed you right there, right? You know, we're light and dark right there, right? So imagine the problem when people try to have 3D movie glasses back in the 50s right there, right? Is that since turning your head right there, right? Made the image go what, light and dark, right? Then basically that was actually bad, because if you tilted your head, all of a sudden, you know, you got a blurry image right there, right? Okay. But now with the modern 3D movie glasses right there, since they're not angle dependent, then people can sit, especially like if you're sitting in the side of the theater, you would actually have to tilt your head a little bit. You know, I think it's only natural like that to do that. And so around the year 2000, or I like to say, you can't say this too often, the turn of the millennium right there, around the year 2000 right there, a lot of technology changed from linear polarizers to circular polarizers, right? And I bring that up because if you try to see this technology now, okay, for instance, in phones right there, you might not see the effect that I was showing you right now about going light and dark by angle dependent right there. That in phones or watches and things like that, right? And it's because, again, one of them is because around the year 2000, a lot of technology changed from linear polarizers to circular polarizers right there, right? Let me see right here. Again, I'm gonna test whether this is a, has a linear polarizer or circular polarizer right there, right? Let me turn on the light, right? Turn on the light, and it goes a little bit light and dark right there, right? Let's see, always on this thing right there. If you see colors right there also, this actually has a circular polarizer right there, right? And again, many modern LCD devices, liquid crystal devices, they now use circular polarizers to get rid of this angle dependency right there, right? It also affects also the dependency of the angle of this. In fact, later on in the video, I'm going to show you, you know, the difference between a TV monitor, or excuse me, a computer monitor and a TV monitor, in terms of liquid crystal displays right there, right? Okay, let's see, here's a fancier version. This one in itself, I don't even, well, okay, let me show it to you like this one. First of all, let's see, let's put this against the light. Okay, I found these the other day in clearance right there, so I decided, okay, the way they work, they go with a little switch right here, they can go light and dark right there, right? And so this made me think, oh, this must have a liquid crystal display right there. Okay, in other words, that this is basically the same technology that that causes light and dark right here, right? In your calculator right there, right? So they're really not as fancy as they would look like this, right? So they're supposed to be fancy sunglasses. And of course, then, you know, what do I do right there? I bring in my linear polarizer right there, right? And what is it that I want to check right there, right? Is, sure enough, right there, they're actually, they have a linear polarizer in them, not a circular polarizer, because this is all angle dependent right there, right? Okay. Amazing the things you can get in clearance right there, right? Okay, so of course, all this technology is very important right there, very modern right there. And of course, something I want you to remember is that, you know, a lot of devices went from using a linear polarizer to a circular polarizer around the turn of the millennium right there, right? Okay. One of them that I noticed a lot was before the year 2000 right there, besides the fact that they were newer right there, projectors. Now here's a pocket projector right there. They were very expensive. I remember somebody didn't want to lend it their projector, right? Because it was $10,000 or something like that, right? And now what, this one I bought again in clearance for $15 right there, right? Okay, and what happened right there, right, is that projectors also went from using liquid crystal displays with the linear polarizers to circular polarizers right there, right? And this one right here, of course, I want to check whether it's a linear polarizer or a circular polarizer right there, right? Whether they've made the difference right here, right? And this, and also I want to show you, here's another very important technology that actually, it, per se, it doesn't use a polarizer, but it actually emits polarized light, okay? And this one right here, what happens is in laser light right there, right? Or a laser pointer right here that has a laser in it right there, right? Of course, you know, don't look at these things right there, right? They'll damage your eyes. But in these things right here, the light that comes out of it has three properties to it, right? One of them, it's monochromatic, which means it's one frequency, right? In this particular case, it's a red one right there, right? The other thing that it has right there is that the light is in phase right there, right? All the light is coming out at in phase, and the waves of the light are in phase right there, right? Okay. And then finally right there, what I want to show you right there is the light that comes out of this laser pointer is also polarized right there. Okay. So for this, I have to actually turn off the light so we can do a little bit of the testing, right? Okay, I couldn't turn off the light completely right here, right? But let's see, let's try some things here on the wall, right? So first of all, again, how am I going to test that this actually has a polarizer in there? Well, I've got my polarizer right here, right? And now I can't do it this way. For instance, here's a little projector right there. Okay, and I'm showing it against the wall. And now I put this in front of the screen right there, right? And I turn right there, right? I don't see any difference right there, right? Even though the light on there, the light that's coming from the projector is considered to be polarized. What happens is that there are some rare surfaces right there that when the light comes out and is reflected off the surface, then we call that surface depolarizing right there, which means that you can't see that it's a polarized image, or that's light that's gone through a polarizer. Okay. So what you have to do instead right there, right, is you actually have to put the projector in front of the light right there, right? And then what you do is, okay, then you turn your polarizer in front of it right there. You have to, let me see if I put it here on the side right there, right? So can you see on the back wall right there, right? The light is actually going now through the polarizer. There it's blocked, and there the polarizers are aligned right there, right? Okay. Same thing happens with the laser light right there, right? If I just put the laser light on here right there, and I put this in front of the screen right there, you're not going to see. You're not going to see that this is polarized light right there, right? So what I have to do right there is I have to put the light in front of the I have to put the laser pointer in front of the polarizer right there, right? And then I have to go ahead and change from I have to change angles right there, right? See, in that angle right there, the laser light is blocked almost completely, and there it gets pretty bright right there, right? So crossed, and then what? And then you can see the laser light right there, right? Okay. Again, I'm showing you all of these, but I think it would be much neater if you went ahead and either got a pair of sunglasses, or better yet, if you kept if you keep a pair of 3D movie glasses, then you'll see all these effects right there, right? Okay. Let's see. We're not finished yet, right there. There's a lot more neat stuff to consider right there, right? And now all this technology, these types of filters that I'm showing you right here, right? These were invented initially, the plastic versions were invented by a fellow named Edwin Land. Edwin Land, he actually founded, when he synthesized these actually in his apartment, okay? And that's why if he could do it in his apartment, I guess close to a century ago right there, right? Then surely we can learn how to make these things also, okay? So Edwin Land, you know, he made this in his apartment. He actually is a college dropout. He was a physics major, I believe, and not a good model. But anyway, that's the truth. Okay. And in a lot of respects, his life was very similar to that of Steve Jobs. He was actually kicked out of his own company. His company actually, the money that he used to that he got from actually making optical polarizers right there, right? He sold some of the technology to Eastman Kodak, the old camera company, and a chemical company too. And he took that money and he founded the Polaroid Corporation. And of course, the Polaroid Corporation became famous for instant photography, right? And that company, the Polaroid Corporation, of course, it doesn't exist anymore. It was as a manufacturer. The brand still exists right there, but the company actually, is defunct. And so when you buy Polaroid products right there, right? The most famous one, of course, was the, products like the Ed, like the Polaroid Land camera right there for instant photography right there. You know, I remember you used to have these little things come out of the machine right there, right? And you would shake them and, well, you weren't supposed to shake them, but anyway, but you would dry them off and all of a sudden you could see an image on there, right? Okay, so the plastic versions were invented by Edwin Land. But this is nothing new right there, right? In fact, in one of the videos I'm going to present, I'll try to give you a little bit of history about all this development right there, right? A lot of coincidental or accidental development. So here I'm showing you a, in fact, let me prop this up on here. Okay, here I'm showing you a periodic table right here. And all of this stuff, of course, is found in nature before. You can actually see if I can zoom in here, right there, right? Okay, and so I hope what you can see here, right, is this is actually a calcite crystal. This is actually calcium carbonate crystallized out beautifully. This is ooh, can you see right there the double image? You know, the double images that you see right there. Let me get this a line right there, right? Okay. And so this phenomenon is called birefringence right there. This is actually a very important phenomena to consider that, for instance, when people make lenses, for instance, for making the tiny computer chips or kind of circuits in the computer chips right there, right? Birefringence becomes a problem right there, right? And so, having these double images right there is definitely an issue right there, right? Okay, so I'm gonna, so again, this looks like bad newspaper print right there, right? Okay. And but I want to show you this is actually an optical polarizer, a linear polarizer. And so the bi is for two right there, right? And it's really two images right there, right? So let's see, I'm trying to get this so we can see it nicely on the camera. Right, maybe I'll zoom out. Okay, so if it looks blurry right there, that's what it should look like right there, right? And then I'll put the then I put the linear polarizer in there right there, right? And as I turn the linear polarizer, what you should see right there, right? Oops, right, is that it should switch from one image to another right there, right? Okay, now, okay, so again, what? Birefringence double image right there, right? Okay, birefringence double image right there, right? And then put the polarizer in front of there right there, right? And then hopefully what you can see is that it switches from one of the double images right there to the other right there. And how am I doing that right there? I have the linear polarizer in front of the camera lens right there. Just to show you that there are two linear polarized frames coming from here right there, right? Okay. So anyway, so Edwin Land got the idea for making his commercial polarizers actually from nature and from the work of other people, okay? But we won't get into history in this video right there, right? Another way that you can make polarizer right there. In fact, at the end of the video, I'm going to go outside and show you some of this right there, right? But you can also make polarized light by reflection. So here I have a piece of glass, and I'm reflecting the light of the overhead fluorescent lamp that we have here. Okay, and I want to show you that that's actually polarized light right there, right? So I'm going to again take the linear polarizer, right? Put it in front of the put it in front of the camera right there, right? And what you should be able to see right there, right? Okay, let me see here. Here's the image right there, right? Is that by turning the polarizer right there, right? Okay. Let me get a good reflection right here, right? Okay. We have a double problem right here, right? Okay, because of the orientation on here, right? We have the glare from the plate itself right there, right? Okay. From the plate and also from the plastic image right there, right? Okay. So what I hope you can see right there is by actually crossing this right there, right? Okay, you can actually cut out some of the glare like this, okay? I'm not getting actually the reflection that I want right there, right? Okay, so I hope you can see that you can actually go from light to dark right there, right? Okay, but this is better seen actually when you use 3D glasses outside right there, right? So hopefully I'll show you that better outside right there, right? Okay, now let me show you again the difference right here between the linear polarizers and the circular polarizers right here, right? And here's some of the mystery of all of this right here, right? Okay, so here I have some linear polarizers right there, right? And of course, linear polarizers can either filter or let light through right there, right? Okay, so here's some strange things on here, right? Why is it if I turn these upside down right there, right? How come all of a sudden they become dark? In fact, if we were doing this in person right there, right? You know, this would be one of the first demos I showed you right there. How strange it is right there, right? Okay. Or if you look across right there, right? And this side, you can see the image, or you can see, and all of a sudden it gets dark on this side right there. See, light and dark right there, right? So you can see through the lens in front of you, but you can't see through the lens that's diagonal to your point of view right there, right? Okay, and of course, if I turn the glasses upside down, then this totally changes right there, right? You can't see in the lens in front of you, but you can see off the diagonal right there, right? We would demonstrate this by using winks right there, right? Okay, and yet here I have a pair of two of the commercial 3D glasses right there, right? And for this right here, right, let me show it to you this way right there, right? Let's see here. I have them next to each other. And if you look at the lens in front of you, you can't see it. But if you look at the diagonal lens right there, right, then again, you can see that right there. And same thing on the other side, and you can't see that right there, right? Okay. But if you turn them the other way right there, right, you turn them that way right there, it doesn't really matter right there, right? So I think that's pretty neat. And of course, if you turn them this way right there, right, that doesn't really matter right there either, right there, right? You know, it gets a little light and dark right there, okay? Other important thing about these glasses right there, right? Of course, it gets light and dark. You look at them this way right there, right? But, you know, if I turn the glass this way right there, it's still dark. But if I turn it on this side right there, the angle doesn't matter right there, right? And so I'm looking at a circular polarizer right now, right there, okay? That's the importance of that, okay? But if I turn the glasses the other way right there, right? And then I turn the glasses right there, well, okay, this is angle dependent. So what I'm really looking at right here is actually a linear polarizer right there, right? Okay. So again, if you have a pair of these 3D movie glasses, go ahead and play around with the world right there, right? Again, don't look at the sun and don't look at laser lights right there, right? But pretty much, you can test for yourself, what is a linear polarizer? What is a circular polarizer? All this technology around in terms of plastic form has been around for 100 years. And yet most people don't realize that it's there right there, right? Okay. Okay, so play around with this right there and learn about this. I'll try to include a clip of what these glasses look like outside. There's a huge polarizer outside. And also what it looks like with a computer screen or a computer monitor like that. Here's one place where linear polarizers have not been replaced by circular polarizers. and it's actually in computer screens, as opposed to LCD televisions right there, right? And I suppose the reason for that is that the fact that when you look at, well, I don't know if you remember the old phones right there, right? If you looked at them certain from one angle versus another angle, you really couldn't see the screen that well. And so in the case of computer monitors, I guess that's considered like a safety feature, whereas opposed to in televisions, LCD televisions right there, that would be a drawback right there. In fact, LCD televisions, now they harp that on the fact that you can actually view them from a wider angle. And of course, that's because they've adopted circular polarizer technology right here, right? So let me just show you what goes on here right there, right? And so again, if you look at your computer screen, you can see that it's a linear polarizer because here I have another linear polarizer. And of course, if I turn the linear polarizer a certain angle, you can't see right there, right? So now the polarizers are crossed right there, right? Okay. So anyway, so linear polarizers haven't been completely replaced by circular polarizers. Here we're outside with looking at the glare or the reflection of the light here. And what I wanted to show you, again, putting in our screen in front of it like this right there, okay, that the light that's reflected off here, which we call glare right there, right, is polarized, and we can prove it by putting our linear polarizer in front of it right there, right? Okay, but I also wanted to show you right here, right? I'm not sure if this is going to show up on the video or not like this, right? But I'm going to put a circular polarizer here, and I don't know if you can see, one of these cars right there, showing up with like a little grid right there, right? And so this is a very neat effect right there, right? When you walk out of a 3D movie, if you still have the glasses on there, you'll actually see this on some cars. I guess it's a type of glass that's under stress right there, which is another use right there, right? But you know, one of the greater uses of optical polarizers, especially linear polarizers or even circular polarizers, is to cut out glare right there, right? Again, using the linear polarizer right there, right? See how you can make reflected light, basically get knock it out right there, right? Okay. But I was telling you there's actually a big polarizer right there, and that's actually the sky right there. That's actually something to consider. I'm gonna put this in front here, and hopefully you can see. Okay, I was actually delaying taking this video right there because of the fact that there were a lot of clouds, which is unusual for our part of the country right there, right? But hopefully you can see that I can make the sky get light and dark right there, right? Because it turns out that the sky, the blue in the sky, actually is due to reflected blue light, and you can see this and the sunset right there. When you see a sunset, the sunset is usually red right there, right? But if you turn away from the sunset, then you see a blue sky right there, right? And this is to consider, for instance, like the moon that doesn't have an atmosphere, because it doesn't have an atmosphere right there, then the moonscapes right there, you know, are actually dark. It's a dark background because no light is being reflected. But of course, our sky right there is actually wet blue, because it's a blue light that gets mostly reflected from the atmosphere. And red light, why is the sunset red? Because it's not the blue light that actually goes through the atmosphere right there, right? So again, get a pair of linear polarizers or optical polarizers right there, and depending on how you look at them, whether you look at them on in one orientation or the other right there, you might see this effect right there, right? But there's a lot to explore using either sunglasses or 3D movie glasses.